In RS485 half duplex application, we will learn about the basic concepts related to the automatic transmission and reception control circuit that controls the communication direction, that is, transmission and reception of serial data, as well as simulations and actual application circuits for the applied circuit. In the RS485 application, we will learn about the basic concepts and structure of automatic direction control, also known as auto direction. Typically, the control pins related to communication direction control for the MAX485 IC consist of the receiver enable RE pin for switching to receive mode and the driver enable DE pin for switching to transmit mode. The logic states of these RE and DE pins determine whether the mode is set to data transmission or reception. Since the RE and DE pins must be independently controlled through separate control lines from the MCU, it is necessary to secure two additional control lines in the circuit design. Additionally, corresponding source code must be implemented in the program, which requires extra effort and considerations. However, if the RE and DE pins, which are related to transmit and receive direction control, are automatically controlled through an auto-direction circuit, the two MCU pins required to implement the RS485 interface can be reduced, and no additional programming effort is needed. When the receiver enable RE pin, the control pin for receive mode in the MAX485 IC is low, it is in the receive state. When the driver enable DE pin for transmit mode is high, it switches to the transmit state. Therefore, if both pins are tied together and set to low, it operates in receive mode, and if set to high, it operates in transmit mode. In other words, by using the transmit signal, TX, from the MCU as an input to the auto direction circuit, a logic high is output during the transmission packet and simultaneously applied to the direction control pins RE and DE. This sets the DE and RE pins to high, enabling transmit mode. When there is no TX signal, the auto direction circuit outputs a logic low, which is applied to the DE and RE pins, setting them to low and thereby enabling receive mode. Now, let's look specifically at the signal flow in the receive mode and the signal flow in the transmit mode of MAX485. First, when logic low is applied to the direction control pins, RE and DE, according to the reception mode function table, if both RE and DE pins are low, MAX485 enters reception mode, and at this time, signals from the A and B communication lines, which are external interfaces of 485, are received, converted into a logic level RX signal through the IC internal receiver, R, and transmitted to the MCU side, the serial reception port. In the case of transmission mode, according to the transmission mode function table, regardless of the state of the RE pin, if the DE pin is high, MAX485 becomes the transmission mode. And at this time, the serial transmission signal TX from the MCU is converted into a signal in the form of 485 and transmitted to the A-B communication lines, which are the 485 external interface pins, through the driver D inside the IC. Due to the nature of the half-duplex communication structure, which must selectively transmit and receive on a single communication line, the transceiver IC MAX485 requires transmission and reception mode settings in order to selectively transmit and receive on the A and B differential communication lines. This mode setting is operated by the receiver enable RE pin and the driver enable DE pin. If both of these pins are low, it is reception mode, and if both are high, it is transmission mode. The auto direction circuit automatically outputs logic high while there is ATX packet signal from the MCU, and outputs logic low in other cases, that is, when there is no TX packet signal. There are three types of these auto direction circuits: a simple method using transistors and a method that applies a 555 timer IC or gate IC. The auto direction circuit is a circuit that generates a logic high pulse during the TX data signal section from the MCU. Let's look at the operation for each method. The circuit using the transistor is a circuit that uses a PNP transistor to invert the logic using ATX signal as input, and integrates the high-speed data pulse with capacitor C3 to create a DC level. In other words, it inverts the TX signal and creates a control signal by forming a logic high signal during the TX packet section. This circuit uses a monostable multivibrator with a 555 timer IC, triggers with the first falling edge of the TX signal to create a logic high, and the duration of this logic high is determined by the resistor R3 and capacitor C2 connected externally. The duration of the logic high of this control output signal is determined by the relationship of 1.1 times R3 times C2. In other words, you can set the R3 and C2 values so that the logic high is maintained for the length of the TX packet, since the TX signal packet length differs depending on the transmission speed or application. Tuning of the external resistor R3 and capacitor C2 is required. In general, as the speed, that is, the BPS, increases, the length of the TX packet also becomes shorter. This circuit uses a signal inversion function, such as a gate IC 7404 inverter or a 7414 Schmidt trigger inverter. It has an operating structure that converts a high-speed data pulse into a DC value using an integration circuit using resistor R6 and capacitor C4, inverts it, and outputs a signal that maintains logic high during the TX pulse section. Diode D1 forms a fast discharge path to quickly enable the control signal to become logic low. To understand the operating mechanism of an actual circuit, let's look at it through simulation. This circuit is an auto-direction extraction circuit of a Chinese USB 485 dongle circuit. When the TX signal is input to the PNP transistor base, an inverted signal is output to the collector, and this signal is used as a control signal. This circuit is a circuit that outputs the inverted waveform of the TX signal rather than maintaining the logic high. Although it is not 100% understandable logically, it operates normally in actual 485 applications. However, there are also reports on the internet that it does not operate normally under some operating conditions. As seen in the auto direction circuit concept and operating structure above, it can be seen that the requirement that the control signal must remain logic high during the TX period is not satisfied. This circuit is a circuit that slightly supplements the previous transistor type circuit, adding an integrating capacitor C3 in parallel with the collector resistor R5. It is a circuit structured to integrate the inverted TX pulse signal applied to the collector, maintain logic high during the TX pulse period, and output logic low when there is no TX packet signal. The upper waveform on the right is a waveform that applies 100 nanofarads to C3, and the lower waveform is a waveform that applies 47 nanofarads. As the capacitance value of C3 decreases, the ripple increases and the discharge time shortens. Due to the time it takes for the capacitor C3 for integration to discharge, the logic low is output after discharge at the end of the TX packet signal. Due to this discharge period, there may be some timing restrictions on fast mode switching, that is, switching between transmit and receive modes, but there is no major problem in practical use. In this way, since there is a difference in ripple and discharge time in the logic high section depending on the capacity value of the integrating capacitor C3, it would be advisable to tune the specific time constant through actual measurement depending on the operating conditions. This is an auto-direction circuit using a 555 timer IC. After being triggered by the falling edge of the TX signal, the duration of logic high is determined by the time constant of resistor R3 and capacitor C2. The duration of the logic high of the control output signal is determined by the relationship 1.1 times R3 times C2. You can see that the duration of logic high increases as the R and C values increase, and the duration of logic high decreases as they decrease. The upper right waveform is the control signal waveform when R3 is 6.2 kiloohms, and the lower waveform is the control signal waveform when R3 is 7.5 kiloohms. You can see that the larger the resistance value, the longer the duration of logic high. This circuit is a circuit that uses the 7414 Schmidt trigger gate IC. The TX high-speed data pulse is integrated by resistor R6 and capacitor C4 to form a logic low signal, and the signal is inverted through the gate to output a logic high. Diode D1 is activated for the rapid transition of the control signal to logic low. Here, the duration of the logic high of the control signal is adjusted by the values of resistor R6 and capacitor C4. If the value of RC is large, the duration of high increases, and conversely, if the value of RC is small, the duration of high decreases, i.e. shortens. Since this circuit may experience attenuation of the original TX signal due to the loading effect of resistor R6 and capacitor C4, circuit compensation, such as adding two buffers or inverting gates before the RC integration circuit, may be necessary. Here is an actual concrete circuit using a PNP transistor. In the case of MAX 485, 5 volts is applied to the V485 power supply, and if MAX 3485, a 3.3-volt transceiver IC, is applied, 3.3 volts must be applied to the V485 power supply. This circuit has been confirmed to operate normally in actual RS485 application tests, but if it does not operate normally depending on the application, appropriate tuning of the C1 value may be required through actual measurements of the TX pulse and auto direction signal. Here is an actual concrete circuit using a 555 timer IC. In this case, the V485 power supply applies 5 volts for MAX 485, and when applying MAX 3485, which is a 3.3-volt IC, the V485 power supply must be applied 3.3 volts, and the LMC555 timer IC can operate at both 3.3 volts and 5 volts. This circuit has been confirmed to operate normally in actual RS485 application tests, but if it does not operate normally depending on the application, appropriate tuning of the R4 and C2 values may be required through actual measurement of the TX pulse and auto direction signal. This circuit is an excerpt from a Chinese USB 485 dongle with built-in auto direction function. Please refer to it.